In my recent review, smartEQ 3, I made a mistake. And today I'd like to correct that mistake and cover another feature that I missed. Let's take a look. But first, I want to let you know that you can purchase smartEQ 3 with my affiliate link below. It's currently on sale for an amazing $40 off until August 7th. So now's a great time to snatch it up, clean up your mixes, and support my channel. And please like and subscribe if you haven't already. In my previous video, I gave a demonstration of smartEQ's intelligent cross-channel processing. I showed how you could make tracks more or less prominent in the mix by reordering them in the group hierarchy layers. It turns out you need to hit Learn All first in order to get the true cross-processing of the EQ between instances. Whoops. Let's see what the real cross-processing sounds like. So I have my project from my previous video. To see how this was set up, go check out that video and come back for this. I have 5 instances of smartEQ on the main tracks, and they're all inside a group in the second instance of smartEQ. Let's hear it with the group off. Now with the group on. So I thought cross-channel processing was already happening because adjusting the group impact changes the sound, and you can hear tracks get louder when you reorder them in the hierarchy here. But you need to hit Learn All first. Let's do that. Alright, so the difference is pretty subtle since smartEQ is already applying some heavy correction to each track. Let's turn it off. But we can hear the difference more if we move the piano up to the top layer. So that's a bigger difference we're hearing. An important feature that I missed in my review was the dynamic mode. If you have a track that has lots of dynamic frequencies, perhaps a vocal or a guitar, you can activate dynamic mode and smartEQ will now constantly track the input and adjust the EQ dynamically. This makes it behave more like Gullfoss or some of the other spectral balancers I reviewed. Not a dynamic EQ, but an EQ that updates itself dynamically. Let's hear an example. So here's a wah guitar lead that, by nature, has plenty of shifting frequencies. Let's let smartEQ learn the track. And it's added some warmth in the low mids and seems to be trying to tame some frequencies in the high mids. So now I'll make the EQ respond constantly by turning up the dynamic mode in the bottom here. So we can see that smartEQ is trying to maintain the same spectral balance even as the signal shifts. And indeed, when we bypass it, we can hear some harshness in the mids come back in. I like how this smoothed out the solo. I think I'll keep smartEQ on this track. So there was my mea culpa. Thanks to Trevor's bass for pointing out my oversight. Now that I've tried the dynamic mode and the learn all function, I can say smartEQ is a very cool plugin that can help smooth out and balance your tracks. Once again, I recommend learning mixing fundamentals first, then turning to a plugin like smartEQ when you need to balance challenging tracks and mixes. That's all for this update. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and use my affiliate link below to get that deal at ADSR. Bye for now.